Welcome back, Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. We got a good one. Queer Eye OGs got 92. Queer Eye New Class got 87. Give me Antoni, give me Ted.
No more Mr. Nice Guy, Antosh.
All right, here we go. Point value is double. Top, I've never, no one's ever went behind me before.
There's a first top, for everything.
He's from Canada.
That's how we do it.
Top four answers on the board. Name a TV host who always makes you laugh out loud.
Alex Trebek.
Security! Security!
Did he just say Alex Trebek?
Yeah, he did.
Alex Trebek!
He's foreign!
But he's really funny in Canada.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Harvey! Yeah.
I told you, it's stressful up there.
Steve Harvey!
You meant other than you.
You said Alex Trebek. I was the worst I've ever felt. One of the great TV show hosts of all time, one of my heroes on Jeopardy, hasn't told a joke ever. Ted, what are you gonna do? Pass or play?
Play.
We're gonna play, sir.
We're gonna play. The job tab. That's what I would have said.
And let me tell you something. If I hadn't have been number one, I'd have tore this card up and walked off.
Right.
I'm not gonna be second on my own damn show.
That's right.
So who the hell they fitting to say? Hey, Jay, let's go, sir. Man. Name a TV host that always makes you laugh out loud.
An icon, a trailblazer, we wouldn't be here, and she's a friend of yours and ours, Ellen DeGeneres.
Bam. Always. Really is. Kyan, this ought to be good. Name a TV host that always makes you laugh out loud.
I'm gonna say Mr. Jimmy Fallon.
Okay. Yeah. My man, Jimmy Fallon, number two.
Yes, sir.
Carson. Carson?
Yes.
What are the odds that you'll get this?
I don't know. There's one question and there's many, many answers. So I think the odds are pretty low. But I don't do math. I don't do math.
I love this dude. His whole thought process is wrong.
Yeah, well, it's circular.
I like the way he works down through a negative answer.
Yeah. Are we indoors?
Name a TV host who always makes you laugh out loud.
Oh, let's see. How about Wendy Williams?
Oh, that's a good one.
I think she's amusing.
Not funny, but they laugh.
Wendy Williams!
Oh!
One answer left.
I'm trying to think of
James Corden, I think.
Show host.
Tom, one answer left, only one strike. Name a TV host that always makes you laugh out loud.
Okay, I'm gonna say Jimmy Kimmel.
Bam!
Yes!
My man, Jimmy Kimmel!
What?
That's what I thought.
That's
that was a good one. That was a good one.
That was a good one.
One answer left. The other team can steal. Name a TV show host makes you laugh out loud.
Stephen Colbert.
Good one. Oh,
good one.
Stephen Colbert.
I like Stephen Colbert.
It's hard. Oh. It's hard, man.
It's James Corden.
It needs to be someone mainstream.
Well, name a TV show host always makes you laugh out loud.
James Corden.
Yeah.
I like him. I like him, man. I do like him. That dude is funny with the karaoke car and he's a funny guy.
Yeah, karaoke car.
Who do you think it is?
Wayne Brady.
Oh.
Gosh darn it. Number four. Feud, everybody, let's get it on. Give me Ted. Give me Tom.
Don't hurt him. He's old.
Oh my God.
I got.
I'm a little nervous.
Top eight answers on the board. Boy, if I had your hair.
I know, right?
Well, you don't even understand.
Jealous, right?
Yes.
Well,
you
can take both of us. But look how nice his hair is.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, I need that.
I have the dollar version.
Need that extra. Name something grandma might put on grandpa in the bedroom.
Oh my God, what's it called? Sleep suit.
I don't remember the American word. I'm not letting you off the hook. Did in your intro, are you not a fashion expert? What the hell is a sleep suit? Sleep suit.
It's the one without the tie.
He's a fashion expert, and he couldn't think of it. It's a sleep suit.
In England, we call it a sleeping suit, but then we call it pajamas here. Yeah.
Pajamas. Tom.
Yes.
Answer.
My answer, blanket.
Blanket. Let's play.
All right.
Good job.
That's so not good.
No, they're good. They're good. They're good.
Here's some art. They're smiling.
Good job. Oh, Steve.
Be careful. You're going to wrinkle your sleep suit.
He said sleep suit. The hell is that? He's a fashion expert.
I was clearly. Get me a sleep suit.
Maybe that's an industry term, a technical term.
Yeah, it's a UK term.
All right, name something grandma might, they want you to huddle.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Hey, Wesley,
get on him.
This the last time, dog.
I told him, wait a minute. I'm sorry.
Ted, name something grandma might put on grandpa in the bedroom.
Maybe some kind of lotion, I don't know.
That's good.
Lotion.
Good answer.
Should know this more than anybody.
Jay.
Yes, sir.
Name something grandma might put on grandpa in the bedroom.
Listen, for different kinds of reasons, I'm gonna go with blindfold. You might need it to sleep or some other stuff.
Oh, kinky grandma.
It's an eye mask to go to bed.
Eye mask. Ryan, we're rolling now, buddy. Let's go. Give me something that grandma might put on grandpa in the bedroom. No strikes.
I'm going to say his teeth.
Put it on his teeth. Carson, my buddy, name something grandma might put on grandpa in the bedroom.
Maybe she'd put grandma on grandpa.
Herself.
Put grandma on top of grandpa. Yeah!
Oh my God. Okay.
Oh my God.
That was a gift from, wow.
That really was.
Tom, you have no strikes. Name something grandma might put on grandpa in the bedroom.
God, clothes, we can't do clothes, okay.
All clothes are up.
Shoot. I don't know.
Everything's up there. This is hard.
Yeah, this
only
is hard.
One strike. Name something grandma might put on grandpa in the bedroom, Ted.
Her hands, back rub.
Her hands.
That's a good answer.
Massage, back rub.
Oh,
oh,
no.
Oh, no.
Jay, yes. Two strikes. Got to be careful.
Yes, sir.
The new class can steal.
I know it.
Name something Grandma might put on Grandpa in the bedroom.
I was going to say, like, sexy underwear, but that's all under clothes, doesn't it?
Right. Yep, sure is.
That's a sexy broad window.
That's a big window.
Lean into that visual. Lean in. I would say maybe she would...
Lean into that visual, really?
Into that visual. But in my mind, I actually
maybe
went.
Grandma would like Grandpa, she'd put on his hair.
Oh.
Put on his hat.
That's a good answer,
that's
too.
That's a good answer.
Okay. Okay.
Possibly. Darn it.
I guess that's not such a good answer.
Second time's a charm.
I'm so sorry for my earlier snafu.
Why didn't you guys just say what your partners put on you?
Oh, we're doing age jokes, of
course.
Oh, the new classes. These are cracks.
We've got to get in their heads. They're winning.
Yes. Well, here we go. Name something Grandma might put on Grandpa in the bedroom.
A CPAP machine.
Oh, that's a good one.
It's possible.
That's
a
good
one.
That's a good answer.
Put on the CPAP. Whatever.
We were way too excited for that.
Number five.
Good job.
Good job. No. Oh, my goodness. Sexy
Grandma.
Underwear.
What is going on in that room?
Well.
I'm
absolutely shocked.
I am shocked. If
you're thinking
we got a game, folks.
That's okay. That is true.
Queer Eye OG got 92. Queer Eye New Class got 87. The goal is shred your points. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Let's get it on. Give me Bobby. Give me Carson.
Wish me luck.
Make a life, Carson.
Family show.
That's too much.
Okay, sorry. We really like each
other. That was too damn much. All right, guys, let's go. We got the top six answers on the board. We asked 100 women.
Oh.
We'll probably know.
Yeah, we will. We got this.
Listen, we asked 100 women, what kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
Booty injections.
Ooh, booty injections.
I think that's number one.
Carson.
Oh, I'm gonna say bosoms.
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 Pass or play? Come on, let's play. Let's play.
We're gonna play.
All right, buddy, let's go. We asked 100 women, what kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
I am going to have to say, Carson, lip injections.
Good
lip
one.
Lip injections.
Oh, my God. How dare you?
Like yours.
Good job, Tommy.
That's a great answer.
Yeah. There we go.
Yes. Right. Lip injections if you're going to keep up with the Harveys, too. Just trying to play along, everybody. This is Ted Allen, everybody, food and wine expert on the original Queer Eye, host of the cooking competition series Chopped and Chopped Jr. All right, Ted, let's go, man. We're talking to 100 women. What kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
I'm gonna go with tummy tuck.
Ooh,
that's a good tummy tuck.
Okay, good answer.
Yes! Good one.
You guys are gonna have to pull that young energy together. Because the OGs is coming with it right now.
We got it over here.
That's good. Jay Rodriguez, everybody. He's a cultural expert on the original Queer Eye stars and Eastsiders on Netflix. Mm-hmm. And he's a big Broadway star also. How you been, man?
Good, man. Excited to be here. This is fun.
Yeah. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. But listen, for me, I would have grown up loved to have seen this kind of representation. These kind of families, I never saw this represented. So this is, thank you for having us.
Yeah. It's 2020.
That's right. We appreciate all kinds of families being elevated. So thank you to y'all.
Let's go.
All right.
Let's go. Mm-hmm. Talk to 100 women. Yes. What kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
I'm gonna say that they would say filler, like injectables in the face to make their face a little. Not that the girls had it, but I think they'd say that.
I think you may have had that. Possibly.
Face fillers.
I knew it was gonna be the first.
Kyan Douglas, everybody. He's a grooming expert on the original Queer Eye and a style pro on the Rachel Ray Show.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Been good, man?
Yeah. It's great. It's a great time.
All right. Good. Yeah. Well, let's play. Only got one strike. Talk to 100 women. What kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
There's not a lot left up there. I'm going to say a facelift. Just keep it general.
Oh, okay.
The facelift! Let's go. Wesley, I'm putting you in charge of them. Because every time I say it, you start laughing. Every time I say they need to huddle, Wesley's ass starts laughing. Wesley, you're in charge of them with the huddle. Okay.
I got it.
One answer left, Carson.
Oh, gosh.
But only one strike. Talk to 100 women. What kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
How about rhinoplasty?
Yeah,
I don't even know
nose
what it's
job.
Called.
Nose job.
I've had a couple. Had a couple.
Good one.
That was a good one.
That's a nose job.
Nose job.
Oh,
no. Oh, what'd you call it?
Rhinoplasty.
It's a nose job.
I saw it on the bill once.
Yeah.
Wait, you've
second one.
Wait, you've already had it done?
Oh my
twice.
God.
You've had it done twice.
Yeah, thank you.
This is his third nose.
Yeah, I think it
Did
looks
you
great.
Pay for it?
It's my favorite one.
It looks pretty good, right?
So what if I can't smell or breathe?
That would help. We live in New York.
Yeah.
He said,
I enjoy it.
So what if I can't smell or breathe?
I've got a mouth.
Do you ever?
Oh, Lord.
Rhino.
Plasty.
Yeah.
Oh, what's left?
I don't know what's left.
I do. There's a couple of things.
What is left?
One answer left, but we got two strikes this time. This time, if you don't get it, the other team can steal. Tom, talk to 100 women. What kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
I'm going to say, and I hope this hasn't been covered by what you said, I'm going to say cheekbones.
A cheekbone plant?
Is that a possibility?
I don't know.
I'm out of ideas. I clearly have none of
them. Cheekbones!
I think it's
I failed.
It's me!
Do it. I don't know.
I think he's got the feeling he has it.
Yeah, we ought to just go right down there. 100 women, what kind of plastic surgery would you need to keep up with the Kardashians?
Dental, big old veneers, teeth.
Veneers! Number three.
We love plastic surgery.
Did you ask?
You're talking to Los Angeles people. Of course we know all the surgeries.
Hey, we got a good game, everybody. We'll be right back.
It's It's time for Celebrity Family Feud. We've got a battle of the Queer Eyes. It's the current cast of Queer Eye playing for Glisten. They're taking on the original Fab Five. It's Queer Eye OG playing for the Trevor Project. And now, the star of our show, Steve Harvey.
Appreciate that, everybody. Yeah, I do. Well, welcome to Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Got a good one for you tonight. These celebrity teams are gonna be battling it out for $25,000 for their favorite charity. So if you're ready for the show to get started, everybody say yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go meet Queer Eye, the new class. Bobby, how you doing, man?
Good, how are you?
This is Bobby Burke, everybody. He's a Queer Eye's interior design expert, has his own furniture line. It's called the Bobby Burke Collection. Furniture. All types of furniture?
All types.
Everything.
Everything.
Sofas.
Sofas, beds, tables, chairs.
Out of sight. Can't touch it.
Well, please do and buy it.
Yeah. That's good, man. Appreciate y'all coming. Introduce everybody.
Oh, okay. Well, this is Tan France.
Hello, everyone. Hello.
Tan is our fashionista.
Yeah, he is.
And
yeah.
He is also the host of Next in Fashion.
Oh, you guys, thanks.
This is our food and wine expert, Anthony Porofsky. His brain is just as good looking as his arms.
Ooh. I'll take that.
Yeah.
And this is Johnny. Jonathan Van Ness. Jonathan Van Ness is our grooming expert, and he is also an Olympic figure skater, gymnastics guru, and a stand-up icon. Yeah. And this is Wesley. Wesley is from season 4. Wesley is one of, don't tell the other heroes, but one of our favorite heroes.
Well, they're gonna know now.
Okay, so Bobby, so what charity are you guys playing for?
We are playing for Glisten.
Which is?
Glisten to the sound. Glisten is an organization that helps young youth in school. So queer youth, LGBTQ, just really helps them find their place and be a part of it.
Okay, great. Welcome to the show. Hey, listen, have a good time today. Have a lot of fun, man. All right, let's get it on. They're playing against Queer Eye OG.
You missed me, didn't you?
This dude, man, I know he messaged with me. Yo, Carson, I try to shake his hand. I'm a hugger.
Hello.
Carson, come on.
I mean, all right.
He always takes it too far.
No, I didn't mean
he takes it too far.
Oh, he takes it too far?
He takes it too far.
You know.
He is a lot.
He's a lot.
He's a lot.
What?
He's a lot.
Carson, you've been on my show several times. You are a lot.
Am I?
You're a lot.
Thank you.
But it's not a bad thing.
Thank you.
It's a good lot.
Thank you.
Extra.
Thank
you. I like it, though. So that's
thank
good.
Thank you.
Carson Questley, everybody, was on season 2 of Celebrity Family Feud, the fashion expert on the original Queer Eye, and currently a judge on RuPaul's Drag Race. Good to see you, man.
Good to see you.
Good. Introduce everybody.
Okay, well, Tom Felicia was our decor devo on the show, and he's designed homes for J-Lo and David Bowie and everybody in between, and has his own furniture collection with Vanguard Furniture.
Yeah. Tom Felicia Home Collection.
Ted Allen from Chopped on the Food Network. Everybody loves Ted, our original food guru. Jay, our culture vulture. Eastsiders on Netflix,
yes,
where
sir.
You can see him now.
Yeah.
And then my good buddy, Kyan, who was the grooming guru, who you can see always on The Rachel Ray Show.
Yeah. That's good. So, Carson, who are we playing for today?
We are playing for the Trevor Project, and they do amazing work. They are a nationwide hotline that provides counseling and a suicide prevention hotline for LGBTQ youth. So they do amazing work.
Now, There's two different energies here. So you all are considered the OGs.
Right, the old gays.
The old gays.
I think that's what it means. No?
I'll walk right into that one.
I mean.
Chad, no.
Oh my God, I thought you were going over there.
My age group over there.
The original gaze, the original gaze.
They picked me to host this episode.
Lucky you.